have discussed about this last parallel reverse procedure. I think we have to start with this mapping of the procedure, right? Mapping over the list. Okay. So, okay. So the thing is like we were discussing with respect to the list. So list means which is nothing but it is sequence of by using sequence of cons we can list out we can list all the elements in a linear fashion, or we can store the elements in the linear fashion like a one-dimensional array. So for that we make use of the constructor cons, which will help us to construct the array elements. So we have seen with respect to how this can be constructed by using box pointer representation, as well as we have discussed how the output representations would be. All these cases we have already discussed, and we started this looking with respect to the procedures, how we write the procedures based on each concepts, how do we change it. So today's class will start with continue with this. So here we will just see how the mapping concept works. So for explaining with this for the mapping concept, mapping procedure, what exactly we are trying to say is, so you are having a list given. To this list, if you have to apply for all elements of your list, if you have to apply any one particular procedure, or if you want to apply, or if you want to scale it up or scale it down with some value, and it has to be applied onto all the elements of your list, then we can go with this mapping procedure. Okay, so the highlight is for this any particular operation to be performed on all elements of your list elements, then we can go with this map procedure. Map, it's a built-in procedure, but you have to know how it how the working of it is. So for that sake, so first thing, before defining the map procedure, first let us see what is the purpose of this map procedure. So for this, we have taken the example with respect to scaling all the list elements with a factor value. Say, as shown in this previous example, if you are given a list of elements, say a list of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 elements, and all the elements of this list has to be multiplied with 10. So that means your expected output is 1 into 10, 10, 2 into 10, 20. So like this, all the elements of the list should be scaled up or multiplied with the value given, which is 10. And the expected output is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So if you have to do something like this, then how do we define the procedure? So scale list was the name given. So as the procedure, we have two arguments. One will be the list element, the other will be the factor by which how much it has to be incremented, decremented, multiplied, what it has to be done. So what should be the content, what we are supposed to have it? And your expected output is again a list. So that means again you have to, once you apply that what operation you have to do onto that each element of the list, you have to pick each element, apply that, do that particular operation onto that particular value, and again reconstruct it back to the list itself. So when we have to reconstruct it back to the list, how it could be reconstructed? For that we should again use sequence of cons, right? How long it has to go on? It has to go on till it reaches all the elements of your list. So when it, and how do we encounter the all the elements of the list we have reached or not? Once we reach the last element, which is nil, right? So for identifying whether it is nil or not, we have the primitive procedure called null. So how many conditions we will have here? We have to just check whether we have reached nil or not. If not, apply the value, whatever has to be applied, it has to be applied and once again reconstructed back to the list itself, right? So we have whether it is null or not null. So we have only two cases. So we can easily go with if statement. So if the given element, so the argument name what we have given here is item, which is nothing but the list. Factor is with what here I am just applying multiplication of this factor value. So with what factor it has to be incremented. So whether the item has reached null if it has reached null, what it has to do? Since we have to reconstruct it back to the list itself, this, once this condition is satisfied, we just have to return null. Okay. If this is not null, then what we have to do? We have to construct it back to the list itself. So how do we construct it back to the list? For that, we can make use of sequence of cons. So keeping that in mind, so first we are having sequence of cons to be generated. So cons of, what should be our first element of for this cons? Cons should be, pick each element from the given list. So first element can be picked, apply that content of the factor. What operation has to be done, that can be applied. So keeping that, we can say that, so here as per this particular example, for whatever is the factor value, apply multiplication of that factor value onto each element of your list. So multiplication of car of item with the factor. Since it is in the prefix notation, this is how we write it. So open bracket, multiplication procedure is called. Again, car procedure is called, applying car procedure onto the items, and whatever it is getting returned onto that particular value, we are applying the multiplication of this factor value. So cons of this one, what should be the second part of our cons? For the second part of our cons, we have to take our remaining elements of the cons, that is remaining elements of the item, and it has to once again come back. So how do we come back? For that, we call the scale list procedure. For the scale list procedure, item has to be reduced. So how do we reduce the item? That means by removing the first element, remaining elements has to be taken into consideration. So for that purpose, we apply CDR of item. Factor part, it doesn't change anything anyways. So factor will remain as such. Okay. So once again, since it has to be iterated again and again, so scale list procedure will be called with the remaining elements of the item, and factor will remain as such. So like this, we keep calling till it reaches the last element. So the last element will be the null. So once this condition is satisfied, it will return nil. So since it will be sequence of cons, cons of first element, then again cons of second element multiplied with the factor, cons of third element multiplied with the factor. Once it reaches null, it will return nil. So by indirectly, it will form it to be as a list itself. If you pass the list element to be as scale list procedure with list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with the factor value to be as 10, then first it will check whether it is an empty list. No. Then again cons will be formed. So like this, cons of 1 multiplied with the factor value 10, then cons of 2 multiplied with the factor value 10, then cons of 3 multiplied with the factor value 10, cons of 4 multiplied with the factor value 10, cons of 5 multiplied with the factor value 10. Again, once it reaches null, it returns nil, that is empty list. So it will just reconstruct it back to the, since it is sequence of cons, we will be getting it to be as a list. So list 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 will be returned. Okay. So same way we can apply, we can do it for addition, we can do it for subtraction, for any purpose we could do it. So for that sake, what we do for that sake, what we have is, we have a built-in procedure called map. So map procedure, how we define a generic procedure named to be as map. So what we have to do is, so here in this map procedure, what you are expected to do is, you whatever procedure you want to apply, or whatever, say for example, in this previous example, we have scaled it up with the value 10, right? Instead of it, if I wanted to apply square procedure onto all elements of the list, then what we have to do? We just have to pass this square procedure and apply it onto the all elements of the list. So the output would be 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, like that, right? Similarly, it could be cube procedure, or it could be whether it is an absolute value or not. So any procedure, if you want to apply it onto all elements of the list, then we could define a map procedure. So how it works is, so when you are defining the map procedure, how many arguments do we need? One will be our input list. So that is the named as the item, the argument which we have named it to be as the item. The next thing will be, what is the content what we are going to apply? That is whether we call it to be a scale up procedure or scaling down, or whether it is a square procedure, queue procedure, whatever procedure it is. So we are just naming it to be as the procedure. So map will have two arguments. One is going to be the list. The second one is going to be the name, the procedure. So by now, all of you know how we can pass the procedure. Either directly we can give the name of the procedure, or we can even write it to be as the lambda procedure. Okay. So keeping this, we are defining the map procedure where we can have two arguments. One is the list. The other one will be the name, the procedure which we have to apply it onto the all elements of the list. Okay. So as we have seen in the previous case, here also, since we have to apply it onto all elements of the list, what we have to do, we will how long it has to go on till it reaches the empty list. So we will have only two cases here also. So if null, if your item is null, then just return nil. If it is not, then we have to form sequence of cons. So how do we apply sequence of cons? Sequence of cons, what will be the first element? First element will be nothing but onto our first element. How do we get the first element? By having the car procedure. So car of item. Onto this car of item, what we have to apply? We have to apply whatever is the procedure what we have passed here, that has to be applied here. Say for example, if it is square, square will be applied onto the first element of your list. Okay, if it is cube, cube will be applied. If it is lambda some procedure, lambda, entire lambda procedure will be written over here. What will be the value passed for this lambda procedure? That will be nothing but car of each time whenever you are calling, car of that particular list will be returned. Okay. What about the second part of our cons? Second part of our cons is nothing but, since it has to apply, since we have to apply this onto all elements of the list, we have to once again iterate this. So for iterating purpose, we are calling map procedure again, where the content of the procedure will not change. That is PROC content will not change. So that will remain as such. So no change for it. What about the list? List has to be reduced because we have applied whatever procedure what we have to apply, that we have already applied it onto the first element, that is car. So that we have already done it. What about the remaining part? Forgetting the remaining part, we are taking we are applying CDR of the list. So CDR of item, and closing the parenthesis accordingly. All the parenthesis needs to be closed accordingly. Okay. So as an one example, if you take out for the first case, map square of list 1, 2, 3, 4, how it works. So it will be first time when you call, it is not an empty list. So cons of, it will be square procedure getting applied. So I'll just write it to be as SQ. Onto what? Car of item. So first time when you call car of item, which will be nothing but it will be 1. Again, we are calling map procedure. It will be a square procedure itself. CDR of it. So CDR of item is, which will be nothing but 2, 3, 4. So again, it comes here. Again, it checks whether it is an empty list. No. So it will come again here. So again, it will be cons of. So cons of first item. Second time when it is getting, when we are saying car of item, it will be nothing but the first item will be these many elements we are passing. So first item will be 2. So we are applying square onto car of list, which is 2. Again, it is not an empty list. So again, we will be applying cons onto the procedure name is square. So SQ. Now, once again, we are passing the CDR means it will be nothing but 3, 4. So car for this particular 3, 4 list, car of means it will be nothing but value 3. After that, again, map procedure will be called with CDR part, so it will be nothing but the value 4, list 4. Now it will be again, since it is not an empty list, it will be cons of, again square procedure getting applied, SQ, car of this list means which is only 4. So car of list 4 means which will be value 4. Again, map procedure will be called, procedure remains square. Again, CDR of it, which will return it to be as nil. So once it reaches here, the condition will be satisfied. You will just return it to be as nil. So all the brackets will be closed accordingly. So now if you see cons of square of 1. So first square of 4 will be applied. Then square of 3 will be applied. Then square of 2 will be applied. Then square of 1 will be applied. So if you see, it will be cons of 1, cons of 4, cons of 9, cons of 16 and nil. So which is nothing but it will be list 1, 4, 9 and 16. If you don't want the name of the procedure to be passed, then we can even write it in form of lambda procedure. So say for example, whatever is the argument which it has to be doubled. So when you have to write it to be as doubled. So here when you are calling this map procedure, what will be the output expected? Can you just try and tell?
10, 12, 14.
So how the lambda procedure it will be called. So here in place of this procedure, it will be replaced with this lambda part. So it will be instead of this part, it will be lambda of whatever lambda of this x. Close the bracket and plus x x. Closing of the lambda procedure. Lambda procedure is closed. For this lambda procedure, since we are having the bracket here, this bracket, so this becomes what? This becomes the procedure call, lambda procedure call. So for this lambda, what is the value which we are going to pass is the car of item. So whatever value you get here, that will become, that value will be taken by this variable x and it will be executed. So here, each time you call apply car of item, it will be once first time it will be 5, second time it will be 6, third time it will be 7. So once you get for each time you get the x value, you are just doubling it. So it will be 5 plus 5, 10, 6 plus 6, 12, 7 plus 7, 14. Since it is sequence of cons, it will be list of 10, 12, 14. Okay. What is the advantage of this map procedure is, so whenever you are having, whenever we have to apply, since this sort of built-in procedures are there, what we can do is whenever you have to apply any scale-up procedures or something, you don't have to sit and define completely. You can directly call this map procedure. So whether you are applying it for scale list procedure, if you are asked to rewrite it, how we can write it by using map would be map. So scale list procedure, where you are applying the factor, that is multiplication, each element of your list should be multiplied with the factor value. So how do you pass the procedure? The procedure which you are passing, it could be lambda of x, whatever value you are getting for this x, that value multiplied with the factor value. So you will be defining just scale list procedure where you have two arguments. One is the item, that is nothing but the list elements. The other one is the factor with respect to when you're multiplying it with what value, that is the factor. So instead of defining again if null and all those things repeatedly, you can directly call this map procedure, where the as a procedure, you can just pass the lambda procedure. You can just define a lambda procedure here. And as the second argument for the lambda procedure, it is nothing but it is expecting the list. So you can directly pass this list, the item which we are having, that could be directly passed. So the advantage is you don't have to sit and define for each and every time for similar type of procedures. You don't have to define it. You can directly call this map procedure. Okay. So you have to just remember map, whatever procedure you are applying, that will be applied on all elements of the list. And it will return the same list itself. Okay, so one more example, the squaring of the procedure. So without using map, if you are defining it, you would be defining it like this. The steps remain same. So since already map procedure is already there, what we could do is we could directly call this map procedure, where we can directly pass the square procedure and just the item. You don't have to define it for each and every time. If the same structure is coming, you can for these type of things, you can directly call this map procedure. Okay. So we'll move on to the next slide. Next topic. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Yeah. Next, moving on to the hierarchical structure. We have already discussed about this hierarchical structure. So what exactly is this hierarchical structure is? Something like this. So already we have seen the, if you are given cons of list 1, 2, list 3, 4, how the output would be coming. We have also discussed how the box pointer representation would be, right? So when we were discussing with respect to box pointer, at that point of time, we have covered how the data structure will be, how the output representation will be. But I haven't named it. So if you are having any contents, that is, if you are having a sequence of list coming into picture, those kind of things, we call it to be as a hierarchical structure. Or we can even call it to be as trees. So I'll repeat. First, what we have done is we have started looking with respect to the single data. So when we are dealing with the single data, if you have to define any particular variable, then we were just defining it, saying define a variable name followed by the value. If it is two values, if you have to just for a particular variable, if you have to have two values, for example, like rational number case, if you have to represent a rational number, you will have the numerator as followed by the denominator. Similarly, if you take up any points, that is x-axis value and y-axis value, there also you will have two points to be represented. So if you are having any particular data which requires two values, then you can construct it by using cons. Then the representation will be define variable name cons of two values. You can directly give it over there. Similarly, if you wanted to have like this array of elements, then how do we list it? So how do we construct it? For that, we can make use of sequence of cons. So when we were saying what is list, list is nothing but it is sequence of cons. Okay. So now if you are having by using sequence of cons, we can form list. So now by using sequence of list or by using combination of cons or list, we will be forming a tree. Okay. So just for highlighting how the output would be for your cons of list 1, 2, list 3, 4. If you remember how we have drawn the box pointer representation for first element, this was our starting part. First content of it, it is nothing but it is again list of 1, 2. So first element is 1. Second, this is null. Here as the second part, which is nothing but again a list. List means nothing but cons of 3, cons of 4 and nil. So again a box which comes 3 here. Already we have drawn this. Which will be 4 here. And a nil here. So how the output would be from here? If it is a sequence of, if whenever it is a sequence, something like this, then everything will be coming within a single brackets. So now when you see here as the first content, again, it is pointing to another box. So whenever it is pointing to another box and it is that box is ending with a nil end all, then this will be represented in one brackets and this content will be represented in other brackets. So if you see, it will be nothing but put together when you write, it will be nothing but a list of, again, open bracket, 1, 2, close the bracket because that is end of it. After that, 3 and 4. Or if you want to expand it and write, you can expand it and write. I'm just representing this to be as the first content, which is A. So when you say it is nothing but list of A, 3, 4. So what is our A? A is nothing but again list of 1, 2. So we can just write list 1, 2, 3, 4. Close the bracket. That same thing in the tree structure also we can represent something like this. So from the final output representation, we could say what is our first content? First content is again a list. So this will be retrieving you the content list of 1, 2. What about the second content, which is 3? Third content, which is 4. From here, for this particular output, what is our first content, which is single value 1. Next, it is a single value 2. So like this, by using this tree representation, also we could analyze it. How we are going to get the values. So sequence of list or by using combination of cons, list, any combination, we will be ending up having mostly we will be ending up having a tree. Okay. So few examples of this tree. Same thing. Now we have already defined a procedure called length for counting how many number of elements we have in a given list. Remember? So length means, which is nothing but where we are supposed to calculate how many elements we are having in the given list. So we have defined it as usual. Whenever it's a list, we will be having the condition mentioned to be as whether it is null or not. If it is null, what we have to just we just have to return the value. So what value? It could be just return the value to be as 0. If it is not null, keep adding 1 plus 1 plus 1 and keep reducing the list element. Hope you remember that. Where is it? We have defined something like define a length procedure. I'll just write len with the variable x. If it is not null, if it is null, we have defined it in both the ways, iterative way as well as recursive way. Right now I'll just write with respect to recursive way. If it is zero, if it is null, just return 0. Otherwise we kept adding 1 and we kept calling the length procedure len just by reducing the list. CDR of x plus is closed, then if is closed, and then define is closed. So something like this we have defined it. So keeping this length procedure, if you count, if I apply for this hierarchical structure, that is for the tree, what will be the length returning? What will be the value, what it returns? Can you tell me for this case? Or for this particular output, if I say say some value y, for this, if I apply car and CDR, what will be the content? Car of y means? What will be the output? If I apply CDR of y? Yeah. Car of y? I didn't get you. Car of y?
Car of y is list 1-2.
It will be list 1-2. CDR of y?
3-4.
It will be simply 3-4 or list 3-4?
List
3-4.
It will be list 3-4. Now if I apply once again CDDR of y, if I apply CADR of y, what will be the values?
CDDR will be list 4, ma'am.
It will be list 4. This one. What about the other one?
List 3, ma'am.
It will be just 3.
It will be just 3. Now once again, if I apply CADDR of y and CDDR of y, what will be the output?
Will be 4, ma'am, first one.
First one will be 4.
Next one will be empty, nil.
It will be an empty list. Empty list I can even represent like this, or I can even write nil. Okay, so now if you see, if I have to if I have to extract each and every each time I'm just applying, see, first time when I applied car, I got the two contents together. Next time when I applied car, I got the value 3. Next time when I applied car, I got the value 4. By the time it reached to null and I came out. Okay. So now with respect to this null length procedure, now if you see, first time car has been applied. So 1, 2 has been already came out. After that, second time when I apply car, it will be only value 3. Next time when I apply car, it will be only value 4, or opposite also, in opposite way also you can say. First time when I apply CDR, it will be nothing but 3-4. Next time when I apply CDR, it will be nothing but, it will be 4. Next time CDR when I apply, it is an empty list. So like this, how many times length procedure has been iterated? It will be just returning the value 3, right? It is considering the list 1-2 to be as a single count, right? So even though we have written this length procedure by using the primitive procedure null, we cannot make use of this the same length procedure. We should have one more primitive procedure which has to be taken into consideration, just for highlighting, emphasize more on this. If I give the second example, consider this to be as the first example. X has been already defined. Second example, list of xx. So how the output would be? List of x and x. So x is already cons of list 1 to list 3, 4. Onto this, I'm just applying again a list. So list of x, x. So the output would be nothing but this was our first x. This is our next x. If you draw the box pointer and if you just analyze, this was our starting part. Here it will be the first value is our x. X we have already drawn. The second part is also an other x, which is an other box pointer, and I'm closing this. So whenever we say this is our complete thing, this is a sequence. So one, everything will come within a single bracket. Now if you see first x, that is pointing to another box pointer. So those contents which is underlined, that is one complete x. The second one underlined, which is the second x. So now if I apply length procedure for this, what will be the output? It will be only 2. Okay, it is not counting each and every element of our contents, list elements, because the structure whatever we have constructed is a tree. Okay. Few more examples. After that, we'll see with the primitive procedure which we have to use. So if you are given the variable x and y to be list 1, 2, 3, list 4, 5, 6. Variable x is defined to be as list 1, 2, 3. Variable y is defined to be as 4, 5, 6. Okay. So if I ask you to apply append procedure to this variable x and y, what will be the output? Append means appending list one content with list 2. Sorry, opposite. You are appending list 2 contents onto list 1.
And it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So the output would be list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now if you apply cons of xy,
will be list of list 1, 2, 3 and another list 4, 5, 6, two elements.
So you mean to say that it will be something like this, single one, you will have one more bracket open, 1, 2, 3, close bracket, one more bracket open, 4, 5, 6, right Vishnu?
Yes,
ma'am, but for the second one, brackets won't come.
Why second one brackets won't be there?
Because that is how the cons work, ma'am. Only for the first.
No. If you just expand and see. Yeah, if you just expand for this, why is nothing but list 4, 5, 6. Other way, if you write, it will be cons of 4, cons of 5, cons of 6, nil. Right, expand and see. It is cons of x, cons of 4, cons of 5, cons of 6. So indirectly what it becomes, it will be a single list. So this bracket will not be coming.
But similarly, we can say for the first cons also, ma'am, but.
But for first cons, it will be cons of 1, right? Cons of 1 it is. It is not like cons of some element followed by cons of. No. It is cons of 1 it is.
Okay.
So that's why it is not forming it to be as a single list. If if you can just draw the box point representation, it will be very much clear.
Yes, ma'am. I will draw and confirm it.
Vishnu, can you draw and see?
Yes, ma'am. Got it, ma'am. Like the from the second one, it's sequence of cons. Missed it.
It will be sequence of cons. So that is the reason whenever you write something like this, cons of x, y. So cons of x, cons of y, if you expand, it will be nothing but cons of 4, cons of 5, cons of 6 and nil. So that entire thing will become a single list. So keeping that, your output representation will be something like this. So it will be single quote. The first content will be nothing but list 1, 2, 3. So this was this from the first box, it is pointing to an other box point, other box with a sequence. So this entire thing will become in a single box. Whereas 4, 5, 6, it doesn't come under a box because it was like a sequence itself. So that was the reason why it doesn't come into another box. Okay.
Yeah, clear.
Now, now you try for this list XY. List of XY. Yes, Hitesh.
List of brackets 1, 2, 3 and again in brackets 4.
Yes. So it will be within brackets. It will be list 1, 2, 3. Again another bracket 4, 5, 6. Why? Because it is list of first content is again a list. Second content is again a list. So you can just see with respect to the box pointer. This first content is nothing but this was our X. This was again another box which gives us the content of list 4, 5, 6 and this is a closing part. So X means it was a list. Y means it was another list. Now if you see this entire thing was a list. So this entire thing was sequence. So this bracket came into picture. What about X? This was again a list that came into another other bracket. This was again a list. So into another bracket. Okay, so I'll stop with this. Continue with the trees in the next class. Okay, so hope it is clear.